Hi, let's talk about the coronary arteries. In this video, we'll discuss the arterial supply of the heart by diagramming the pathways and branches of the left and right coronary arteries. So the coronary arteries begin their journey in the root of the aorta. That's the portion of the ascending aorta that is most proximal to the heart. There is a right coronary sinus of Valsalva and a left coronary sinus of Valsalva that feed the right and left coronary arteries, respectively. Notice that these arteries are traveling through the coronary sulcus. Coronary sulcus gets its name from the coronal plane, well, the largely coronal plane that it occupies. Coronary doesn't mean heart. Coronal means crown, and so the arteries are named for the sulcus that largely contains them. Also recall that the aortic valve only closes during diastole, and so the RCA and the LCA only fill with blood during diastole. Let's start our tour with the right coronary artery, hereby referred to as the RCA. So that is originating in the right coronary sinus. It leaves the ascending aorta and enters into the coronary sulcus, and its first branch is the sinoatrial nodal branch, or the SA nodal branch. This is supplying the SA node of the heart as well as portions of the wall of the right atrium. This is a branch of the RCA in about 6 out of every 10 individuals. In the remaining 4 out of 10 individuals, it's a branch of the left coronary artery. The RCA then travels down in the coronary sulcus, down towards where that right border meets the inferior border. And along the way, it will give off branches to serve the right ventricle. And one of these is a named branch called the right marginal branch. The right marginal branch is going to hug the inferior border of the heart. The RCA then wraps around here. Let's pick this up here. Wraps around within the coronary sulcus and goes out typically to a region known as the crux of the heart. This is going to be important later on. That crux region is typically the area where two other branches arise. There's the AV nodal branch, or the atrioventricular nodal branch, and then the posterior interventricular branch. The posterior interventricular branch is communicated along the posterior interventricular sulcus, and that branch is going to have septal branches that supply the interventricular septum. Now, in almost 70% of individuals, these branches are supplied exclusively by the RCA. In the remaining amount of individuals, they are either supplied by both the RCA and the LCA, a condition known as codominance. So RCA and LCA serving the crux is codominance. Or exclusively by the LCA in a minority of cases, and that's a condition known as left dominance. So if it's by the RCA, it's right dom, by both codominance, and by the LCA left dominance. And we'll see this further. So let's look at these branches cadaverically. Here's the origin of the RCA. There's the SA nodal branch. There's the coronary, right coronary artery descending down in that coronary sulcus. At the bottom there, we can see the right marginal branch. We can get a better look at it from this anterior lateral view. You can see more of the right surface and border of the heart. And there is that right marginal branch going out along the inferior border. So the RCA then wraps around. So it's coming around there. This is an interesting orientation. My apologies for it. And we can see the RCA continuing to serve the crux of the heart, where we have the posterior interventricular branch and the AV nodal branch. So this is an example of a right dominant heart. Here, the septal branches are drilling deep into that myocardium and into the interventricular septum. So let's take a look at the LCA. The LCA arises from the left coronary sinus. It travels behind the pulmonary trunk into that coronary sulcus, and it branches into the anterior interventricular branch, also known as the left anterior descending, or the LAD. That will host septal branches supplying the interventricular septum. The other branch is the circumflex branch. The circumflex branch stays within the coronary sulcus and wraps around to the posterior aspect of the heart, sometimes getting to that crux of the heart, but most of the time not getting there. One branch off of the circumflex is the left marginal branch that hugs the left border of the heart. Curiously enough, out of all of the branches of the coronary arteries, the left marginal is the only one designated as an artery and not a branch. But let's look at these on the cadaveric photos. There's the origin of the LCA. We can see that we have a very early split for the anterior interventricular branch. Then we have the circumflex branch, and that wraps around. There is our left marginal artery. You can probably see it better here. In fact, we can. There's the anterior IV branch. Here's the circumflex coming down, and then there is the left marginal artery. So as I've said before, heart dominance is determined by the coronary artery supply to the crux of the heart. Whichever arteries get to the crux, which is where the AV nodal branch and posterior interventricular branches arise, are the arteries that are going to determine dominance. Most hearts are right dominant hearts, so 67% of them. And then there is no clear consensus in the literature for exact percentages that vary between codominance and left dominance. But codominance, where both the RCA and LCA supply the crux, is the next most frequent condition. And the least frequent condition is left dominance, where the LCA supplies the crux of the heart. Let's for a moment imagine why left dominant hearts are at a selective disadvantage. With a left dominant heart, we would have the anterior interventricular branch as well as the posterior interventricular branch supplying the interventricular septum by the LCA. So that's a lot of real estate. That's quite a bit of the walls of the ventricle that would be supplied exclusively by the left coronary artery. If there was any occlusion of the LCA, it would be absolutely catastrophic, not just for the walls of the ventricles, but also for the cardiac conductive system, so the bundle of His and the bundle branches that are conducted down along through that interventricular septum. So we've discussed the left and right coronary arteries and their branches and what they supply and how they contribute to heart dominance. This is your summary slide. Thank you for your time.